But ladies and gentlemen, with that, we now move on to a very special invitee, a guest of honor for the day, who's nothing but the Iron Lady of University of Kalania. She became the first female vice chancellor to be appointed to the University of Kalania when she assumed her duties on the 28th of August 2020. She's had a remarkable career in the field of medicine and in the sphere of university education and administration spanning several decades. She obtained her MBBS from the University of Colombo in 1986 and went on to obtain a Master's in Medical Parasitology from the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine, UK, and MD and Board Certification in Medical Parasitology from Colombo University's Postgraduate Institute of Medicine. She joined the medical faculty of the University of Colombo in 1991 as a lecturer and then joined the newly established medical faculty of the University of Kalania in 1993. She served as the Dean of the Faculty of Medicine, University of Kalania, from 2012 to 2018. She worked as the Director of the Quality Assurance Council of the University Grants Commission of Sri Lanka from December 2018 to August 2020. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let me now take the honor and privilege of inviting Senior Professor Nilanthi De Silva, the Vice Chancellor, University of Kalania, and the guest of honor for our day to address the gathering.
President of SLUSA, the chairpersons of the university advisory boards, the directors of physical education, the university students, the sportsmen and sportswomen who are with us today, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen, our compere very rightly said, I've been in this office in the University of Kalania only just for a few weeks, and it gives me a lot of pride and pleasure to welcome you here this morning and celebrate IDAS together with you. I know that our team here in the University of Kalania has taken a lot of trouble in putting this event together, and they have done so with a lot of pride. And so, once again, I would like to warmly welcome you to the university. We've had a lot of introductions about SLUSA, about IDAS, and the activities that are organized through IDAS. I would just like to reiterate that my strong belief that knowledge and skills are really, really not the only attributes that we should aim to develop in our undergraduate students, and that I go back to a phrase that was used really quite early this morning, that we need to nurture a positive mindset with a healthy mind in a healthy body. And that is something that we need to encourage and nurture among our students so that they, when they graduate, can contribute optimally to national development. We now have many students who compete at both national and international level and do really well in many different sports, as well as a large number of other undergraduate students who participate in sports activities. This has gone hand in hand with development of the infrastructure for sports activities in this country, as well as the development of a sporting culture. I have to confess that I am no sportswoman at all. I'm totally uncoordinated, and never excelled at any kind of sport whatsoever, even in my earliest days in school. But I do have I come from a family where sports has always been important to my brothers, to my husband, to my son, to my nieces and nephews. And so I really appreciate the value of sports and what it brings to character building in school children as well as in undergraduate students. As a medical professional, I'm also very aware of the need to encourage and raise awareness about the importance of physical exercise in a country where the incidence of what we call diseases that are associated, lifestyle diseases, like diabetes, hypertension, ischemic heart disease, things that are associated with obesity and a sedentary lifestyle are threatening to overwhelm our country. And so I am very much aware of the need to encourage people to engage in physical exertion, exercise, not just occasionally, but on a regular basis. And so I really appreciate the initiatives that FISU and perhaps IDAS will promote in terms of not just organizing sports events, but also the other educational programs that you offer. And there was something that I picked up on what I think Akhila Nilavira mentioned, the idea of a healthy campus. We've taken on board in Kalaniya the idea of a green university, the concept of a green university. But similarly, I think our country will benefit greatly from not just thinking about nurturing heads and minds, but also encouraging on a daily basis for people to, students and staff, to think about what it is that makes a healthy body in addition to a healthy mind. So, celebrating IDAS here today will no doubt further enhance the value of sports and all the sporting activities that already take place in our universities. And I really extend my warm good wishes to everybody today, the keynote speaker and the panelists and those who will be taking part in the other events that are going to take place today, and then also the future activities of SLUSA as we go into the future. So thank you very much, everybody. You have my best wishes.